If you've been wanting to find a mentor or a coach that you can hire to help you with your business, but you're not really sure how to find a great mentor, who to pick, there's so many out there, you're not really sure which one is for you, this video is for you. I'm Sylvie McCracken from sylviemccracken.com, and today I want to share with you my tips for finding a great mentor or coach for your business. So here is the deal. Very similarly to when we hire an assistant, sometimes we have this tendency to go for clones, right? So for people that are just like us, for people that have, you know, people that we want to be friends with, really, is what we end up being drawn to. That's just our nature. And so we have to make this conscious decision not to do that. For example, as I've talked about, when we hire an assistant, you don't really want to hire a clone that has the exact same skill set that you do and, you know, the exact same weaknesses that you do. So, you know, just like when you're hiring an assistant, you want to find someone that complements, you know, that has strengths that are your weaknesses and vice versa, right? So that you can be a great fit together. Well, similarly, when you're finding a coach or a mentor or someone to learn from, you really want to find someone that A, has the skills that you're missing, that you really want to learn. So if you know that sales is a big weakness for you, then maybe you find a coach or a mentor or a program or a course that can teach you that skill, right? So you want to learn how to market yourself better. Maybe that's where you go. As opposed to, maybe you know your copywriting skills could use some improvement. Well, maybe you find someone that can teach you that skill instead. Now, this is not going to be a clone of yours, right? Because, you know, chances are that this is not a strength of yours and you need their help. So that's one big tip. And then B, you know, something that I've seen people make this mistake way too many times, so it was time to bring it up. Here's the thing. Don't hire a coach or a mentor or join someone's mastermind whose business you don't aspire to, or you don't look up to, or you don't want to emulate. So here's what I mean by that. So for example, if you want to, you know, create a more leveraged business, if you want to learn how to create passive income streams in your business, don't hire someone that has no idea how to do that and whose entire income source is based on one-on-one client work. Do you know what I mean? So you want to find someone who knows how to create the business model that you want to create as well. So that is a whole other skill set, right? That's a business model thing in addition to those particular skills. So if you're a speaker and you want to become a better speaker, then hire someone that has that skill set and could teach it to you as well. And similarly, if you want someone that could create passive income streams, that might be someone like me or someone that has that skill set in other areas of expertise that you're looking into. And of course, I would love to help you. I don't work with too many people one-on-one, but I do have some other programs. So of course, if you're on my list, you will hear about those when they're open. I would love to hear from you. If you've hired a coach or mentor, how did you make that pick? How, you know, did you make any mistakes in those picks? Any regrets that you have? Leave them in the comment below. Let's start a conversation around this, and I will see you there.